Hi, this is Dr. Neela Bakure, and now we are starting with another chapter in the unit of reproduction, and the chapter is reproduction in humans. When reproduction in humans term is discussed, it is not like one short step. There are many steps which are involved. Let us understand the steps and then we will take up all these steps in detail. First, and reproduction when we are talking of, it is sexual reproduction that we are going to discuss. First step is gamete formation, that is gametogenesis. Gametogenesis includes, if it is formation of sperms, that is male gamete, then it is known as spermatogenesis. And if it is egg or ovum formation, then it is known as oogenesis. So, what is taking place in this step? This is the first step, that is gamete formation. After the gametes are formed, the next step is transfer of this gamete, male gamete, from the male body to the female body. It is known as insemination. Insemination includes transfer of male gamete into the female reproductive system or tract. When the gamete, male gamete, that is sperm, has been transferred into the female reproductive tract, then the sperm will start to move towards the egg and then fertilization will take place. Fertilization is fusion of the male and the female gamete. After fertilization, the structure of the cell which is formed is called zygote. So, this zygote will start to move from the place where it is fertilized, that is fallopian tube, to the womb or uterus. During this process, it undergoes splitting or cleavage. When cleavage takes place, one cell divides into two, two into four, and then ultimately a ball of cells will be formed, then it will develop a cavity. So, in this we would be talking about morula formation, blastula formation, when the zygote is dividing. Now, when this ball of cells reaches the uterus, it has to get implanted there. So, then next is implantation. Implantation is fixing of this structure into the endometrial lining of the uterus. After it gets fixed, the cleavage is taking place already. It simultaneously gets fixed into the endometrial lining, and during this process only, there are three germ layers which are formed. That is endoderm, mesoderm and ectoderm. That process is known as gastrulation. Gastrulation is formation of three germ or germinal layers. We will discuss all these steps in detail. Then placenta formation. Up till now it was implanted, it was anchored there. Now a connection is formed between the maternal tissue and the fetus, which is called placenta. So placentation. After the three germinal layers are formed, these layers will give rise to various organs and systems. So, organ formation will take place, it is known as organogenesis. That is organ formation. Once the organ formation is complete, the structures are fully developed, that means by this time the embryo or the fetus is fully formed so that it can come out in the open world. That step is known as parturition. Parturition is expulsion of fully formed fetus after completing the gestation period. That means that gestation period should get complete. By that time the fetus is fully formed, and now if the fetus is released from the body, then that process is known as parturition. Definitions, details, we'll take step by step. This complete is or can be considered as the various steps of reproduction. After fertilization till parturition is known as gestation period. Gestation period is from fertilization to parturition. In case of human females, this gestation period is approximately 280 days or 9 months. The longest gestation period is in elephants. It is about 22 months, slightly shorter than 2 years. So, in human females, in about 280 days, and we are talking of approximately, because it is not exactly 280, it may vary from female to female. There are various conditions which decide this, but approximately 280 days or 9 months, fully formed fetus is expelled from the mother's body, that is parturition. So, this period is gestation period. Now, before we take up all these steps in details, we need to know where are these actually taking place. Where does spermatogenesis, oogenesis take place? Where does insemination take place? Fertilization, site, how cleavage? That means we need to understand the male and the female reproductive systems first before we can even start with these things. So, first let us talk about the male reproductive system, then female reproductive system, and then we will start with gametogenesis. So, let us talk about male reproductive system first. In a reproductive system, there is a primary reproductive or sex organ and accessory sex organs. So, primary sex organ is the one which actually produces the gametes. So, in case of male reproductive system, the primary sex organ is a pair of testes. These testes, they produce two things. One is sperms, and second, the male sex hormones, that is androgens. The most important androgen that we talk of is testosterone. Androgens are male sex hormones. So, two things are done by the primary sex organ, that is a pair of testes. Then secondary sex organs. Secondary sex organs are the ones which help, and that is why they are also known as accessory sex organs. So these are the structures which are going to help. They do not produce sperms or the hormones. So the main function is performed by the main organ, and that is why it is called primary sex organ. These are all just helping structures. Which are these helping structures? There is epididymis, one with each testis, so a pair of testis. Let us write down the numbers here. It is 2 in number, epididymis also 2. Then a duct which carries these sperms, it is known as vasa differentia or vas difference. Again a pair, one from each epididymis, this duct arises. Then two ducts fuse with the urinary duct, that is urethra, to form a urinogenital duct. This is one in number, because from both the sides the vasa differentia would come and they would join only one urethra to form urinogenital duct. In human males there is an external copulatory organ which is known as penis. One, it is the external genitalia. Along with these structures there are some glands which help. Seminal vesicles, one on each side, so again two in number. Then there is a chestnut or a donut shaped gland which is known as prostate gland. It is single, so let us write one here, and there are two, again a pair of very small peanut shaped glands which are known as Cowper's glands, two in number. So male or primary sex organ, testis, two functions performed by this: gamete formation. So if it is a male reproductive system, the organ is going to be a pair of testes and the gamete is sperm, plus they also produce the hormone, the male sex hormone, androgens. The most important androgen is testosterone. Then there are some helping organs, secondary sex organs or accessory organs. Most of these are the ducts which acting as passage or epididymis, where some changes will take place in the sperms, and all other structures, glands helping, but main function is done by testes. So this is the complete breakup of organs of male reproductive system. Now let us draw the system and see how these structures are arranged, and simultaneously we will also write down their functions.